Hey there, friends! On a hot summer day, you can turn a regular fluorescent lamp into a DIY air conditioner that cools down to an incredible minus 35 degrees Celsius.
Instead of throwing away a broken fluorescent lamp, I decided to give it a second life and turn it into something truly useful. Now, if you didn't know, fluorescent lamps are coated inside with a special substance called phosphor. This phosphor glows when hit by ultraviolet light, which is created by mercury vapor inside the tube when electricity flows through it. Pretty amazing, right? All that science packed into a fragile glass tube? Sure, the gas inside my lamp is long gone, but even in this state, it deserves careful handling. Always wear gloves, safety goggles, and a respirator. Safety comes first, even when working with something that seems like just a bit of old junk. We'll get to the compressor, fan, and other components a bit later. But first, I ordered a vacuum generator from my favorite site, jlcmc.com. This tool is crucial for removing air and excess moisture from the system before we fill it. If you want your setup to work reliably and efficiently, this step is a must. JLCMC has a huge range of mechanical components, from basic fittings to high-precision parts. Whether you're a DIY enthusiast, an engineer, or part of a serious production team, you'll find exactly what you need. I especially recommend checking out their aluminum enclosures. Some are as cheap as 80 cents. And their clamps and brackets? I've ordered them multiple times. They're sturdy, reliable, and surprisingly affordable. Honestly, I haven't found this level of quality at these prices anywhere else. And guess what? The package arrived in just 6 days. That's impressively fast, especially for international shipping. If you're curious and want to check it out for yourself, the link to the store is in the description below the video. Go take a look. The product quality is excellent, the delivery is fast, and JLCMC regularly surprises customers with bonuses and discount coupons. For example, new users get $60 in coupons just for registering. JLCMC is a true mechatronics marketplace, combining thousands of components, industrial-grade standards, global shipping, and amazing prices. It's the perfect place for engineers, makers, and manufacturers to bring their best ideas to life. To make the condenser, we'll need copper tubing about 4.8 millimeters in diameter. You can usually find these tubes at specialty stores that repair or sell air conditioners, refrigerators, freezers, or heat pumps. The condenser is a crucial part of refrigeration and air conditioning systems. Its main job is to release heat from the hot compressed refrigerant gas, turning it back into a liquid. Imagine this. After the compressor squeezes the gas tightly, it becomes very hot. The condenser cools this gas down by releasing heat into the surrounding air, so the refrigerant turns back into liquid and gets ready for the next cooling cycle. Without the condenser, the system simply won't work efficiently. The heat would stay trapped inside, and you wouldn't get any cooling. Besides the condenser, the air conditioning system also has a very important part, the evaporator. Its job is a bit different. The evaporator absorbs heat from the air inside the room to cool it down. One key difference is that the copper tubing for the evaporator is usually about half the diameter of the condenser's tubing. This is because the refrigerant evaporates inside the evaporator, cooling the air, which requires a larger surface area for heat exchange and proper pressure inside the tubing. So, if the condenser is like the laundry room where heat gets washed away, the evaporator is the real fridge inside your room. To make the whole system work together, the condenser and the evaporator need to be connected. And that's where the capillary tube comes in. This tiny but mighty tube plays a crucial role. It regulates the pressure of the refrigerant, turning the liquid coming from the condenser into a cold mist, ready to evaporate. Think of it like a little gateway, letting the refrigerant sneak from high pressure to low pressure so the next cooling cycle can begin. Clever, right? To connect the evaporator to the capillary tube, I first had to slightly modify the pipe. I carefully widened its inner diameter using a drill, all to make sure the capillary tube fits tightly and securely inside. This method is simple, but quite effective, especially in a home setup. And to be able to fill the air conditioner with refrigerant and properly vacuum it beforehand, we'll need a filling port. And here's the interesting part. Instead of using a specialized fitting, you can easily use a suitable part from a car. For example, a valve stem from a car or bicycle inner tube works perfectly. Sometimes, the best engineering solutions come from thinking outside the box and a bit of good old ingenuity. And what's an air conditioner without a compressor, right? We'll need a high-pressure compressor that runs on 10 to 15 volts. It should be capable of operating in the pressure range of 0.8 to 1.3 bar, which is ideal for keeping the system stable and circulating the refrigerant efficiently. The compressor is the heart of the whole system. It's what keeps the refrigerant moving, creating the pressure difference between the condenser and the evaporator. Now we're connecting the compressor and the fan in parallel. Our air conditioner is going to be a classic on-off type, simple and straightforward. Unlike inverter models, this kind of system doesn't need any extra microchips or electronic components. You just supply power, and the compressor and fan run continuously. No fancy control boards or variable speeds. Of course, if you want more control, you can always add a thermostat to shut the system off when the temperature reaches your set point. But even without it, everything works just fine. Simple, reliable, and sometimes simplicity is genius. Did you know the first air conditioner was invented way back in 1902? It was created by engineer Willis Carrier. And get this, it wasn't designed to cool people down. Its main purpose was to control humidity in factories, to prevent paper and ink from spoiling. Only years later did people start using this technology to make life more comfortable on hot days. Modern air conditioners do way more than just cool the air. They filter dust, regulate humidity, and some models even clean themselves or connect to your smartphone. A critical stage in assembling this system is ensuring complete airtightness of all connections. For this, I use specialized flux and solder with a melting point around 500 degrees Celsius, materials that provide a reliable and durable metal bond. I pay close attention to the quality control of the solder joints, as even the slightest leak can compromise system efficiency or cause failure. Therefore, precision and meticulousness during this process are the foundation for the successful and stable operation of the air conditioner. We're almost at the finish line. With the vacuum generator and compressor set up, it's time for one final, but very important step, vacuuming the system. This process removes all the air and any remaining moisture inside the system, which could interfere with the refrigerant's performance. Plus, creating a vacuum allows us to add more refrigerant into the system, improving both efficiency and reliability. So yeah, vacuuming is absolutely essential. Think of it like taking a deep breath before getting to work, clean, dry, and ready to run. Calculating the exact amount of refrigerant needed for a DIY system like this is pretty tricky. So I took a practical approach. I filled the system with as much refrigerant as it could handle, then started carefully testing its performance. If the system overheated, behaved unpredictably, or showed signs of instability, I would slowly release a bit of refrigerant and run the test again. Step by step, I found the perfect balance, the point where everything ran smoothly and efficiently. It's kind of like tuning a musical instrument. A little more, a little less, and suddenly, you've got that perfect chill performance. Despite the massive effort and nearly 2 weeks of non-stop work, full of trials, errors, tweaks, and experiments, we finally managed to create something truly incredible. This isn't just a homemade air conditioner. It's the result of patience, creativity, and a real passion for building things from scratch. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And to make sure you don't miss the next invention, hit that notification bell. Your support truly inspires and motivates me to keep creating more fun and useful projects. Thank you so much. See you next time, and bye-bye.